Hi friends, this is Rajni Priya from Vyans Medical Academy. Now I would like to discuss about thermodynamics. The subtopics in thermodynamics are extensive properties, intensive properties, state function and path function. Next one, first law of thermodynamics, Hessler, Gurr, relation between delta H and delta E and relation between delta G, delta H and delta S. First, what is meant by thermodynamics? Thermodynamics means flow of heat. It deals with the quantitative relationship existing between heat and other forms of energy in physicochemical process. First friends, we will discuss about some important definitions. There are extensive properties, intensive properties, state function and path function. Extensive properties. The properties which depends upon total amount of the substance is known as extensive properties. The examples of extensive properties are mass, volume, enthalpy, entropy, internal energy, Gibbs energy and heat capacity. These are the examples of extensive properties. And next one, intensive properties. The properties which independent upon total amount of the substance is known as intensive properties. The examples of intensive properties are pressure, temperature, density, specific heat, surface tension, viscosity and molar properties. These are the examples of intensive properties. And next one, state function. The properties which depends upon initial and final state of the system is known as state function. Examples of state functions are enthalpy, entropy, internal energy, Gibbs free energy, pressure, temperature and concentration. These are the examples of state functions. And next one, path function. The properties which depends upon path of the system is known as path function. The examples of path functions are heat, work, heat capacity and specific heat capacity. These are the examples of path functions. So friends, these examples are very important in heat point of view. So please concentrate on these examples. And next one, thermodynamics. Thermodynamics consists of four laws. They are zeroth law, first law, second law and third law. Now we will discuss about first law of thermodynamics. It is impossible to construct a perfect motion machine is known as first law of thermodynamics. By the equation Q is equals to delta E plus W, Q means heat absorbed by the system, delta E means change in internal energy, W means work done. If work done on the system, work done will be considered as positive. If work done by the system, work done will be considered as negative. As well as friends, Q absorbed by the system, Q will be positive and heat released by the system, Q will be taken as negative. And next friends, Hessler. Hessler is based on first law of thermodynamics. The total energy change in a reaction is same, whether it is one step or in several steps. Hessler. For example friends, A2D, formation of product directly in single step, that is A2D, then their enthalpy is Q. And formation of product indirectly in several step process, that is A2B, B2C and C2D. Single step, that is A2D, then their enthalpy delta H is equals to Q. And several step process, A2B, then their enthalpy is Q1. And B2C, then their enthalpy is Q2. And C2D, then their enthalpy is Q3. Formation of product directly in single step process is equals to formation of product in several step process. So friends, delta H is equals to delta H1 plus, delta H2 plus, delta H3. That means Q is equals to Q1 plus, Q2 plus and Q3. Next one friends, work. To displace an object against force is known as work. Work is equals to force into displacement. What is graph? At constant pressure, isobaric. At constant temperature, isothermal. And adiabatic. And last one, isopoiled. At constant volume. Work done in isobaric is greater than work done in isothermal is greater than work done in adiabatic is greater than work done in isopoiled. This means work. And next one friends, relation between delta H and delta E. Delta H means change in enthalpy and delta E means change in internal energy. By the equation delta H is equals to delta E plus P delta V. We know friends, P delta delta nRT. So we can write as delta H is equals to delta E plus delta nRT. Delta N means number of moles of gaseous products minus number of moles of gaseous reactants. So if delta N is equals to 0, then delta H is equals to delta E. If delta N greater than 0, then delta H greater than delta E. If delta N less than 0, then delta H less than delta E. For example, friends, C plus O2 gives rise to CO2. Solid state, gaseous state, gaseous state. We know, friends, delta N is equals to number of moles of gaseous products minus number of moles of gaseous reactants. So, friends, NP minus NR is equals to, in product side, there is only one mole of CO2 present in gaseous state. So, 1 minus, in reactant side, carbon is in solid state, so we can neglect this. And what is in gaseous state, it consists of 1 mole. So, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Then, N is equals to 0. That means, delta H is equals to delta E. Friends, another example, CaCO3 gives rise to CaO plus CO2. CaCO3 is in solid state, gaseous state. Delta N is equals to number of moles of gaseous products minus number of moles of gaseous reactants. In product side, there is only one mole of CO2 present in gaseous state. So, 1 minus, in reactant side, there is no gaseous reactant. So, 1 minus 0 is equals to 1. So, friends, delta N greater than 0, that means delta H greater than delta E. Friends, another example. N2 plus 3H2 gives rise to 2NH3. Gaseous state. We know, friends, delta N is equals to NP minus NR. In reactants, in product side, there is 2 moles of NH3 is present in gaseous state. So, 2 minus, in reactant side, 1 mole of N2 present in gaseous state and 3 moles of H2 present in gaseous state. So, 3 plus 1, 4. 2 minus 4 is equals to minus 2. So, delta N less than 0. That means delta H less than delta E. Next one, friends, relation between delta G, delta H and delta S. Delta G means change in Gibbs energy and delta H means change in enthalpy and delta S means change in entropy. By the equation, friends, delta G is equals to delta H minus T delta S. If delta G equals to 0, then the system is in equilibrium state. If the reaction is non-spontaneous at all temperatures, then delta G is positive, delta H is positive and delta S is negative. If the reaction is spontaneous at all temperatures, then delta G is negative, delta H is negative and delta S is positive. If the reaction is non-spontaneous at low temperatures, then the reaction represents delta G positive, delta H positive and delta S positive. And if the reaction is spontaneous at low temperatures, then delta G, delta H, delta S, these three represents negative values. And if the reaction is non-spontaneous at high temperatures, then delta G is positive, delta H and delta S are negative values. If the reaction is spontaneous at high temperatures, then delta G is negative, delta H, delta S are positive values. Friends, this table is very important in need point of view. And finally, we discuss about some key points in thermodynamics. If gas transfer from high pressure to low pressure, then work done will be negative. If the gas expands in vacuum, then work done is equals to 0. Volume is constant, delta is equals to 0. Automatically, work done is also 0. In reversible process, work done in maximum, then irreversible process. So, friends, these examples and this table is very important in need point of view, friends. So, please concentrate on this table and these examples. This topic is also very important in NEET point of view, friends. Thank you, friends. I wish you all the best for your NEET competitive examinations. Thank you.